Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time on my channel, thank you so much for clicking. I am quite sure that this video will convince you to subscribe to my channel and join the family. My name is Amara Ozo and I am a Nigerian who lives and studies in Germany. I create videos about my life in Germany. I upload vlogs, sit down videos, get ready with me, chit chat and all that good stuff. So please subscribe and join the family. And if you are a returning subscriber, hi! Hi my loves! I hope every one of you is fine. Today's video is all about the quintessentials of choosing a university in Germany as an international student or maybe a regular person who already lives in Germany. So if you are interested in what I have to say, and guys, you don't want to miss it, I promise you do not want to. Thank you for watching. My number one criteria for choosing a university will be your desired course and language. Of course, this one makes absolute sense. No one goes ahead to choose a university without first of all checking if they offer the desired course and in what language. Now in Germany, we have maybe not so many, but some bachelor courses are being offered in English language, while a whole lot of master's courses are being offered in English language. Please, I beg you to take out your time to make your research, go to the school website and find out the course that they offer. Maybe you might even find something else more interesting than what you previously had in mind. So, number one, first and foremost, you would want to check if they offer the course you want to study and then the language. Like I said, 90% of their courses are in German language. So, for an international student, this is where it gets very interesting. You want to check the international student ratio of that particular university because it will give you an insight to what the university is all about. If there are a lot of international students, so that tells you that the university is quite accommodating and also a good reputation when it comes to international students. Not all universities are like that. Honestly, not all universities are friendly to international students, and mostly where you see more of international students, such universities have more courses being offered in English language. I don't think there are any other languages in German universities, so it's either English or German, which makes absolute sense. So yeah, I as an international student would definitely choose a university with a higher ratio of international. This also gives you the ability to interact with other international students because it's quite easier, you know, so just learn about their struggles and just how to navigate life in Germany as a foreign student. Third, and I think this is the most important one, is the cost of living in that particular city. Germany has a lot of excellent universities. In my last video, I talked about top 10 universities in Germany. If you have not seen that, I would encourage you to go see it and then come back to watch this video. So in that video, I gave you guys the top 10 universities according to the QS ranking. Now, the cost of living is very important because you want to know how expensive is that university or that particular city. The cost of living now entails how much is the semester contribution. As you might know, before you embarked on this journey, Germany does not pay tuition fee. State universities in Germany are tuition free. So what you pay is basically like a semester contribution. When it comes to cost of living, you want to check how much does a rent in that particular city cost? How much does food cost? How much does transportation cost? How much does, what else? Maybe electricity or water? You know, all those utility bills that you have to pay, how much do they cost? Most cities in Germany are quite expensive. According to the QS University ranking, two universities in München are making the top chart. But I would have you know that München is an expensive city. München boasts of a lot of students, but it's not the cheapest city in Germany. So that is where, I don't know, you might want to kind of take caution and, you know, just go for another city that also has a very wonderful university. All the universities in Germany, I would say, are very excellent, but then yeah, some are more than some. Yeah, As an international student in Germany, you would want to live within your means. You do not want to spend a lot of money just on rent or food and all that. Number four point that I will make today is the job offer. Now, this is where it gets a little bit tricky, yeah? So most big cities where the cost of living is quite expensive is also where the highest job offers are. I know, let's take a city like Frankfurt, for example. Frankfurt University is exceptional, very beautiful, and the academic structure is very wowoo. I attended my student colleague and also my language courses in Frankfurt, and I have my aunt in Frankfurt, so I basically kind of live in Frankfurt part-time, you know. So Frankfurt is a very beautiful city. It's a huge and big city. It's also a student city, I will tell you that. There are a lot of students in Frankfurt, and that is because there are so many job offers in Frankfurt. There are so many things you can do. Frankfurt is a city where you will hardly have a hard time looking for a job. There are so many student jobs ranging from gastronomy, part-time teaching, or even helping out in the university. So I don't know, it's kind of a tricky situation here. I would highly recommend that you research about the job offers in the city that you have chosen to study in, because it doesn't make any sense that you are studying in a stellar university but then there is no job for you to finance your education. This is just Germany's way of being very kind to international students. Before you come to study in Germany, you either have a sponsorship letter or a blocked account. I have a video on all of this on my channel, so please go watch them. I will not be talking about them right now. I have a lot of people who ask me on a daily basis if they are allowed to work as a student in Germany. Yes, definitely. You are allowed to work in Germany and finance your education. But then it's only part-time and you have a very, very limited amount of hours to work. The fifth criterion that I would mention today will be hostels. You want to check out how many hostels does a university have and how much does it go for and where is the location of these universities. And also you want to apply very, very early. University hostels are quite cheap, so they tend to be given out quickly, you know, so it's like first come first serve. As soon as you are getting your application letter, please go and apply for a student hostel. Number six will be infrastructure. Someone like me, I really pay a lot of attention to infrastructure because I do not like old buildings. I do not like old universities. I know this might come out vain or something, but I don't know. There's just something about studying in a very nice and beautiful university. It just gives it this touch. Like, even if I'm not in the mood to go to school or to study, when I remember my university, like, it gives with this job. For example, Goethe University in Frankfurt, it is so beautiful. My student colleague didn't take place at the main campus, but I found myself and also so many of my classmates, we are always going to the library at the main campus to study there because it was just so beautiful and conducive. There's this thing about the environment that just gives you all the energy you need. I don't know if you understand what I mean, but someone like me, it is quite important. So I also look out for infrastructures of the university. Another point that I will make today is the course outline. You definitely want to check how long does this particular course last. 3 years, 2 years, when does it start? Does it start every winter semester or every summer semester? Now, I know that major courses in Germany, like major science courses in Germany, start only in September. They start only in winter semester. So these are the things you really want to put into consideration while applying or while choosing out a university. Some courses are quite practical than the other in some universities, so you really want to take your time. Like, application and study in Germany is very tedious, I am telling you the truth. So you want to sit down and make your research and know that you have all the necessary information. What are the differences in a particular course when it comes to two different universities? Like, I would want to know that and at the end of the day make the best decision. So definitely look out for the course outline and basically what the university has to offer as far as that particular course is concerned. My last tip for today will be transportation and accessibility. Most universities in Germany tend to scatter their campuses, you know, within the city, so you really want to check, you know, how how far is one particular campus to another, and also to your hostel, and you know, just what's the proximity to the main city or to the train station. This point might not be the most essential thing that you would go for, which is also why it's the last, you know, but sometimes it helps. So guys, this brings me to the end of this video. I just hope this video helped one or two persons, and if it did, please give it a thumbs up. Check out my other videos about studying in Germany, and yeah, follow me on Instagram. My DM is always open. I answer questions about studying in Germany, and I basically just share my life over there. Let's get chatting in the comment section below. Are you already studying in Germany? What do you think are the essential criteria when it comes to choosing a university in Germany? Is there something that I have missed? Thank you so much for watching, and please do not forget to subscribe. I shall see you in my next video. Bye.